Hi guys, this is Nazmul Simam and you are watching Gateway Solution. In this video, I am going to solve a lead code question based on array, and question goes like this. Given integer array nums, return the third maximum number in the array. If third maximum does not exist, return the maximum number. So if we have input array something like this, 3, 2, 1, we have to return the third maximum. Here first maximum is 3 and second maximum 2 and third maximum is 1. We have to return 1. If we have array with only 2 elements, we have to return the maximum of it. And hopefully you understood the question. Now we will try to understand how we will approach toward the solution. So first I will take one example. Suppose example array is 2 1 1 4 3. So here we have the number of element as 1 2 3 and 4. So length of this array is going to be 5, and what we have to do, we have to return the third maximum. In this case, third maximum is, first maximum is 4, second maximum is 3, and third maximum is 2. So we have to output 2. And if you notice in question description, when you go down, our value, the array element value, can be from minus 2 billion to plus 2 billion. So we have to keep this in mind, because if we place minus 2 billion here, element something closer to minus 2 billion, then we have to deal with like we can't give max as like minimum max as 0, because we have to consider negative element also. But don't think about that now. First we will see how we will proceed toward our solution. So what we will do, we will take three variable, max 1 which will be the first maximum, and max 2 which is going to be second maximum, and max 3 which is going to be third maximum. And what we will do, we will iterate over our array, and we will iterate from 0 to n minus 1. So using for loop, we will iterate from 0 to n minus 1, in this case 0 to 4. So how and what we will do, we will check if max 1 equal to null. Now you might think that how you can assign null value to the integer. So here is the catch. We are not we will not write int here directly. Instead of that, we are going to use wrapper class. We will write integer reference, and integer reference, and we can initialize reference variable with null in Java. So hopefully you got it. If you don't know about wrapper class, try to watch some videos. There are many resources available in YouTube, because here we have input from minus 2 billion to plus 2 billion. So if we will assign max 1 as 0, there might be some value which is less than 0. So we might face problem. So instead of that, we will use wrapper class, and in this reference, wrapper integer reference, we can use dot equals also. So that is amazing thing about this. And here when we are inside for loop, and we will declare I equal to 0, here also we, instead of int, we will use integer wrapper. And what we will do here, first we will check max equal to null. Is it true? If it is true, or why we are checking this, because if we are at index 0, and of course max is going to null, and no matter what is there in index 0, we have to store it in max 1. So because when we will store the first index, then we will compare with other upcoming index. And after that, what we will do, if I is greater than max, if either max equal to null or I greater than max 1, then what we are going to do, in max 1 we are going to store, we will leave some space, because in max 1 we will store I. And similar case with this, else if same, max 2 equal to null or I greater than max 2, we will store i into max 2. And after that, else if, I will make it little bit so that we are able to write all the thing. Else if max 3 equal to null, then we will check this also, I greater than max 3, then we will inside, here we have write wrong thing, I inside max 2, not max 2 inside I. And what we will do, I inside max 3. Inside max 3, I will store I. So this condition will not work now, but we will make some update as we iterate over it, and we will see the solution. And what we will do now, we will go with 0th index when I is 0. What will happen? When I is 0, at that particular time, max 1 is obviously null, so this will run and our max 1 will become max 1 and here max 2 and max 3. Our max 1 will become 2, right? And if already happened, so else if will not run, else if will not run. And now in next index, when I become 1, this is null only, null, null, and we will check if max equal to null. No, this condition is not true when I is 1. So now max 1 we have as 2, and if I greater than, here I is 1, if is 1 greater than 2, no, again this condition will not run. So we will come to the else if, and in else if max will remain same. In else if we have max 2 equal to null. Is max 2 equal to null? Yes, it is null. If you see here, max 2 is null. So what will happen? We will assign I to max 2. So 1 will be sit at max 2, and again max 3 will be null because it is else if. After that we have else if. So now when we will be at third index, what will happen? We will check for max 1. At third index we have 1, and is it max, is 1 greater than, is 1 greater than 2? No, of course not. So max 1 will remain same. And is 1 greater than 1? No, of course not. It will remain same. And again max 3 will become 1. And now when we will add index 3, we already add, this is index 2 guys, not 3. When we will add index 3, this is index 2. When we will be at index 3 and we have value 4. Is 4 greater than 2? Yes, it is greater. So this will run, and now max 1 will get updated and max 2 will remain same, and max 3 also will remain same, right? But if you see, here is the problem. Since our 4 become max 1, so what should happen here? The thing which we want here is to shift this max 1. When we update max 1, we want to shift to max 2, max 2 to max 1, right? And when we will do this, so we have to update our code. We have to shift first of all max 2 to max 1 and max 2 to max 3 and max 1 to max 2. We have to do this. So what we have to do here, max 2 to max 1. In max 2 we will store max 1, and in max 3, in max 3 we will store max 2. Hopefully you understood this, because when we are updating new value to the max, so we have to shift all the previous value so that our max will be something like 4, 2 and 1, so that our all max will get updated, because this is the requirement. And now similarly, when we will update max 2, so when we are going to update max 2, suppose we are going to update, now let's see the fourth index and you will understand there. In fourth index what will happen? Is 4 greater than 3? No, so 4 will remain 4. And is now, now what will happen? We have 2 and 1. But what is the problem here? If you see, we have problem here. We want here 3 at second index. So when we are updating max 3 to max 2, and in similarly we have to do here, when we are updating max 2 and what we want max 3, we will assign the previous value to max 3. Previous value of max 2 to max 3, so that the order will maintain. So this is the code. But if you see, we end up many times we end up doing repetition. So to avoid repetition, we will check first one condition. If I dot equals to any of this max 1 or I dot equals max 2 or 3, we are going to skip this. Suppose if we have some value of I, we already have in max 1 or max 2 or in max 3, then updating it is useless. It's just a waste of time. So it is just going to improve our increase our time complexity. So what we have to do? We have to do this thing which will reduce our time complexity. So after this whole for loop, what we are going to do? At last, we have to return third max. Return third max. And if you remember the question, a question says that if there is no third max, in this case it is max 3, if there is no third max, if there is 2 element, then what we have to do? If max 3 is null equal to null, then we have to do what? We have to return second max. Not second max, max of both, which means return first max, max 1. Hopefully you got the complete approach. Now I will try to write in code. If you didn't understand here, I will try to make you understand there. Please concentrate. So what we are going to do, we are first going to do use wrapper class, and in wrapper class of int, which is integer max 1 equal to null, and similarly max2 also null, and max3 also going to be null. And after that we are going to iterate over the array, given array which is nums. And how we will iterate? For int I, we are going to use for each loop, so that we have to type less. Hopefully nothing bad happens. Like if we need some explicit kind of manipulation, then we can't use for each, but in this case I think we can use. So first of all, we will check for equals, right? I'm trying to write in sequence as we have discussed earlier. So if I dot equals, and here also we have to do use a wrapper class, because we can't use a dot equals with the primitives integer. If I dot equals max1, and I will copy it and paste two times. Max 2 and max 3. Then what we are going to do, simply continue. We are going to skip this step. Continue means we are going to skip the current step. And break means we are going to exit out from the loop. Continue. And if, well, max, yeah, so that everything is more clear. And if max 1 equal to null, then, or we will check one more condition, or I greater than max 1, then we will do max 2 equal to max 1 and max 3 equal to max 2. We have to understand the sequence. In max 3, we want to lose max 3 here. We don't want to lose max 2. So we have to override max 3 first, not max 2. So this is the way. That my bad, I have written wrong there in explanation. Hopefully you got it. We have to override. If we will override max 2, then how we will get max 2 in next step? So we have to override max 3 because we don't need max 3 anymore. We want to update max 3 with max 2 and max 2 with max 1 and max 1 with our new max value, which is I. Hopefully you got this, and this is the most important step which we are going to do in all other questions. And if max 2 equal to null, max 2 equal to null, then, or I greater than max 2, then what we are going to do, we have to update max 2. We are updating max 2, right? Max 2 with I and max 3 with max 2. Yeah, it's simple. Max 2, we will first update max 3. We will replace max 3 with the previous max 2, and we will update max 2, current max 2. And at last, we can't use if only. We have to use else if. Again, here else if. Hopefully you're understanding what I'm doing. Else if max 3 equal to null, then we will check if I greater than max 3. If this is true, then what we are going to do, simply max 3 with I. Hopefully you understood this whole step. And at last, what we have to do, return max 3, return return max 3. Yes, and before returning max 3, we have to satisfy that condition also. If max 3 equal to null, we have to return max 1. Hopefully everything is clear and our solution will get accepted. We will get some error. Wow, our solution got accepted. Expected output is 1 and we are getting output as 1 only. Now I will try to submit. Hopefully it will get accepted. Yeah, it got accepted. Now we'll see the details how we perform. Yeah, you are here, your runtime is 70% of Java submission, so it is good. And you are here, your memory use beats 28.05% of Java submission, which is okay, not cool, but we meet all the requirements. And hopefully you enjoyed the video. Consider sharing and subscribing. Thank you guys.